Permanent maxillary first and second premolars are very similar, which makes it important to know even the smallest of difference between the two teeth. Starting with some general features, first premolar is the fourth tooth from the midline and second premolar is the fifth tooth. This gives the two teeth different tooth numbers in various tooth notation systems. Chronologically, the first premolar erupts at 10 to 11 years of age and second premolar at 10 to 12 years. If we take a look at their measurements, we see that all the dimensions of both the premolars are exactly the same. Morphologically, the crown of second premolar appears more rounded than first premolar. Moreover, a major difference is seen in the roots, where the first premolar has two roots and second premolar has one root. Now, let us study the various morphological differences in detail from each aspect, starting with the buccal aspect. Both the premolars have a trapezoidal outline form. The buccal cusp tip in first premolar is distal to the midline, whereas in second premolar it is mesial to the midline. In first premolar, the mesiobuccal cuspal slope is longer than the distobuccal cuspal slope, whereas in second premolar it is just the opposite. Both the contact areas in first and second premolar are in the middle third, but those in the second premolar are more occlusally present than the first premolar. The more occlusal placement of contact areas makes the cusp height of second premolar appear shorter than the cusp height of first premolar, which results in the cusp tip of first premolar appearing sharper than the second premolar. In both premolars, the buccal ridge running from the cusp tip to the cervical line are seen, but is less prominent in second premolar. Coming to the lingual aspect, the differences in the outline form of the teeth from the buccal aspect are same in the lingual aspect as well. Moreover, in first premolar, the lingual cusp is smaller than the buccal cusp, whereas in second premolar, both cusps are almost of equal height. Next, the mesial aspect. The crown is trapezoidal in outline form in both the premolars. The difference in the height of the lingual cusp is seen from the mesial aspect as well. In first premolar, the lingual cusp is 1 to 2 millimeters shorter than the buccal cusp, whereas in second premolar, they are almost of same height. The occlusal table in first premolar is larger than second premolar, which means the distance between the buccal and lingual cusp is more in first premolar than in the second premolar. On the mesial marginal ridge of the first premolar, a mesial marginal developmental groove is present. However, no such groove is present on the second premolar. Coming to the root, in first premolar, the root bifurcates into buccal root and lingual root, whereas there is a single root in second premolar. Next, the distal aspect. All the differences seen from the mesial aspect are seen from the distal aspect as well, except for the developmental groove, which is absent in both teeth. Finally, the occlusal aspect. The outline form of the first premolar is hexagonal, whereas in second premolar, it is more of oval shape. The lingual convergence seen in first premolar because of the smaller lingual cusp is not seen in second premolar as both cusps are equal in size. The mesial and distal pits are present in both the premolars, but in second premolar they are closer to each other in comparison to that in first premolar. As a result of this, the central developmental groove running between the two pits in second premolar is shorter than in the first premolar. In the second premolar, there are numerous supplemental grooves radiating from the central groove, but not in first premolar. This makes the occlusal surface of second premolar to have a wrinkled appearance.